And so we come to the seventh and last lesson of Unit 1, which asks, what basic ideas about rights did the state constitutions include? So let me ask you, what did the colonies do to establish themselves as functioning free and independent states?
Well, all of the former colonies except Rhode Island and Connecticut quickly set about the task of writing constitutions for their new governments. Eight of the new states did so in 1776. New York and Georgia came in a year later, so their constitutions were in place by 1777, and Massachusetts by 1790 had its constitution in place. Connecticut opted to function under the fundamental orders of Connecticut that it adopted after separating from the Massachusetts colony in 1639. And it adopted its first constitution in 1818. What I find intriguing about this is we have states well after the United States Constitutional Convention continuing that tradition of we are at least semi-sovereign, if not sovereign states, and we will adopt our own constitutions. Rhode Island had adapted its crown charter from 1663. It didn't write its own constitution until 1842.
What ideas about government were included in the state constitutions?
All of the states agreed that their constitution should be written, as opposed to remaining unwritten, like the British constitution. They all agreed that their constitution would serve as a higher law, that is, a framework identifying the branches of government and what the powers and limitations of those branches were and how the branches should interact with one another. Now, that's a choice that is different from using the Constitution to really write public policy. And so there was a major choice made to continue in the tradition of a Constitution as a fundamental structural document rather than a policy document. Legislatures were not given the power to alter constitutions. A great example or demonstration of how much we have abandoned the notion of parliamentary sovereignty, how much we have rejected our British roots. Legislatures, like governors, are bound by the Constitution. All of them, all of the constitutions, reflect the concept of popular sovereignty. And when we look at the Virginia Bill of Rights, which is Article 1 of its Constitution of 1776, we will see that. Many of the states did create strong legislative bodies, even though they denied their legislatures the right to alter the Constitution. And the assumption was that with respect to the day-to-day laws of the state, the legislature should be sensitive and represent, if not reflect, the will of the people. Now, that said, Massachusetts, based on its own experiences, opted for a much stronger executive form than the other colonies. However, the executive was subject to a very short elective term. All of the states treated their constitutions as a contract between the sovereign people and their government. What's interesting is that there were such differences among the states about who qualified as the people. That's going to be one of the big challenges in 1787 at the Constitutional Convention. We were not uniform about who we thought were people who were qualified to participate in government forms. All the state constitutions adopted at least some form of separation of powers. We had talked earlier about how the crown would attempt to perform all three governing functions, making laws, carrying them into effect, and judging them, that those functions were not identified as being limited to being performed by separate bodies. The state constitutions start to experiment with that notion of separation of powers, particularly between the legislative and the executive branch. Judging is not really understood to be a separate function. It's mentioned in some state constitutions as a separate branch, but with no mechanism that establishes or creates that branch. It was fairly common for judging to be done by legislative bodies and sometimes by executives. But the concept is there. Virginia went farther than any other state constitution in demanding a rigorous separation of powers in its Bill of Rights. And we're going to be looking at that, I hope, before we finish today.